Nilambujashyamalkomalangam Sita samaropitavama bhagam Panavu maha sayaka charu chapam Namami ramam raghuvanshanatham. Irrations Lord Rama, whose complexion is like a blue lotus, very tender and delightful in appearance. Sita is seated on his left side. Is carrying powerful bow and arrow in his hands. Sri Ramcharitmanas, Aranyakhanda, and Doha number 20. Presently, the context of this storyline, Shurpanakha's nose and ears have been chopped off by Lakshmana, and led by Shurpanakha, Khara, Dushana and Trishada, three great demons, the brothers of Ravana, Kumbhakarna and Vibhishana. These are two spirals, Mala, Vikshepa, Avarana, gross impurity, mental distraction, and the veiling aspect brought by ignorance in two stages. First stage is the beginning stage. The second stage is the last stage. In other words, Khara, Dushana and Trishida, that was one spiral. When that finished, now we have the last spiral waiting. That's Kumbhakarna, Ravana and Vibhishana. Presently in the storyline, Shurpanakha has now come to contact her brother Ravana and to compel him to fight against Rama. धुआं देख खरदूषण केरा जाय सुपनखा रावण फे प्रेरा सींग खरदूषणा त्रिशरा बॉडीज बीइंग क्रीमेटेड सींग द स्मोक कमिंग आउट द क्रीमेशन शूर्पणखा रश टुवर्ड्स रावण इन लंका with the intention of presenting false causes. She never says that she went after Rama to be wedded to him. All that she said that she saw wonderful woman with Rama and she wanted to take her for her brother Ravana. So it's a false. Boli bachan krodh kari bhari, desh kosh kai surati visari. And with her face full of indignation and words bitter with wrath, in other words, in a very angry disposition, Shurpanakha addressed her brother Ravana. How did she start? You have forgotten to rule your country and to handle your treasury. Karasipana sovasi dinurati, sudhi nahi tab sir par aarati. You drink liquor. Day and night you are just sleeping. You have no information. What has enemy done to me? and that big enemy that's after you. Rajaniti binud bhadana binudharma harihi samarpe binusat karma. Royalty cannot be handled without righteous conduct. Prosperity cannot be handled without dharma, following the path of virtue. Good karmas cannot be performed unless one surrenders to God. Now all these words are words of wisdom. The words of wisdom, whether they come from Shurpanakha or from Ravana, they are perfectly welcome. And Tulsidas ji loses no opportunity. Because sometimes people are more focused on what Shurpanakha has to say. So then hear words of wisdom through her lips. Though from storyline, she is quoting the scriptures to pursue her own intention. Vidya bin viveka upajaye. Without viveka, discriminative vision, one cannot gain success in gaining wisdom. Wisdom is the perfection of practice of viveka. Viveka is that inspires you to do vichar, who am I? And enables you to see your identity different from body, mind, intellect, etc. And led by viveka, you look at all pleasures of the world, purposeless pleasure, as a source of misery. Sarvam dukkam vivekina. So all that without vidya, without vivek, wisdom cannot be attained. All one's effort will be full of perspiration, no inspiration, if there is no practice of viveka. Sangate jati kumantrate raja, manate gyan, panate te laja. Sannyasis become pursuer of negative karma. They become perverted by Vishaya Sangha. Vishaya Sangha means falling under the lure of worldly pleasure. And a king becomes perverted when he is given a wrong counsel. When pride develops, one's wisdom, he becomes restricted. And sattvic conduct of modesty runs away if you are a drunkard. All these are words of wisdom. Priti pranaya binu madate guni nasahi begi niti asasuni. Without love of God, one does not develop real goodwill towards others. And thus have I heard from sages. Ripuruja pavaka papa prabhu ahiganiye na chota kari asakahi vibhida vilap karilagi rodan karan. Oh, Ravana, my brother, these items should never be ignored. What are they? Enemy, disease, fire, sin, the role of one's Lord and Master, and even a snake, even though they are very small. Your enemy is seems very harmless, but be careful. He can place one little thorn in a way that will stop your big journey to 20 hotels. I'm joking. Disease, be careful. Don't ignore it. Go after it. Remedy it along with all your sadhana. Fire, don't ignore it. If you are just seeing glowing fire a little, it will blow up your whole house if you ignore it. Pap, sinful karma, you should not ignore it. That what I have done is just very simple. Sinful karma is just like fire, spark. It will spark up your whole mind gradually. Swami, those who are your master, those who are, if you are doing business, so those who are your boss, on a path of satsanga, those who are guiding you, they are called Swami. And their teaching should not be ignored. Their orders should not be ignored. And even a little snake looks so how cute, can bite you. Sabha maj paribhyakul bahuprakara kaharoi tohi jiyat dasakandhar mori ki ati gati hoi. So in the royal court of Ravana, in the midst of all the people who had there, who were present in that assembly, Shurpanakha began to cry and weep and began to scold Ravana. While you are alive, O Ravana, O ten-headed brother, look what has happened to me. Surat sabha sad uthe ukapulai, samujhai gahi baha uthai. Hearing these words, the entire assembly became agitated, and Ravana got up, lifted Shurpanakha by her arm, and began to console her. He asked, "Oh, Shurpanakha, who has done this to you, made you so ugly, chopped off your nose and ears? Who has done it? Now you see how she presents the what has happened. She is not telling exactly, but to fulfill her intention, she presents it in a spicy way, spices it up. Avadh Nripati Dasharatha ke jaye, Purusha Singha Bana Khelan aaye. The son of King Dasharatha, who is like a lion among men, he has come to hunt down enemies. All the Rakshasas, demons, are his enemies. And he has come to hunt them down like a hunter. Samuji pari mohi unhe kahe karani, rahit nishachar karihai dharani. I have come to understand his purpose of coming. He wants to free the earth of all forces of darkness, all demons and asuras. Jinkar bhul bal bhuj bal pai dashanan abhay bhay picharat munikanan. Supported by his Rama's strength, the strength of his arm, sages and saints are now feeling free in their ashrams, and they move around in the forests freely, without fear. Dekhat balak kal samana, paramadhir danvi gunanana. Rama, Lakshmana, they look at young men, tender, but they are very embodiment of terror, death. They are supremely heroic, expert in discharging arrows, possessing countless virtues. Atulita bal pratap dau bhrata, kalabhadrat sur muni sukhadata. Both brothers, Rama and Lakshmana, they are endowed with amazing strength and glory. They are engaged in destroying all the asuras, all these demoniac forces. And they are the giver of joy to sages and saints. This is the storyline, but from a more deeper point of view, Rama is Jnana movement, Lakshmana is Dhyana movement. The role of Jnana and Dhyana, role of pursuing path of wisdom and practicing meditation leading to Samadhi, that role is meant to destroy the demoniac nature within yourself. Every human being is a blend of divine, godly, human, and demoniac. And the divine is promoted by, remember the root letter Da. The divine is promoted by Dhamma, controlling the mind and senses. Human aspect is promoted by Dana, charity. The demon aspect is sublimated by Daya, compassion. So everyone has to work in the blend of these three. So, coming back to the storyline, Rama is the embodiment of, he is the abode of beauty, being supremely handsome. He has a woman with him who is young and most beautiful. Rupa rashi vidinari samari rati shatakoti Jitasu Balihari. Creator has put all his talent in creating Sita. Trillions of Rati, the wife of Cupid god, is called Rati, who is the beauty behind all women, Rati aspect. Millions of that Rati and that beauty is found in Sita. It is Rama's younger brother who chopped off my nose and ears. Why? Learning that I am your sister, and in order to ridicule you, they chopped my ears and nose. Karadushan suni lage pukara, chan mahak sakal katakaun hamara. I sought help from Kara and Dushana and Trishira. They all came to help me with big army. But within a moment, Rama destroyed them all. Hearing the death of Kara, Dushana and Trishira, Ravana was burnt up, began to burn up as it were by his inner anger, wrath against Rama. Swamiji samujhai kari bal bole si bahu bhanti gaye bhavan ati soch bas neend parai nahi raati. In many ways he tried to calm Swamiji, but internally he himself was afflicted with great worry, and with that worrisome mind he went to his palace. He could not sleep. He began to reflect within himself. Sura nar asur nag khag mahi more anuchar kaha kau nahi. Who can dare hurt us, gods, human beings, demons, nagas, literally implying snakes, but these are allegorical descriptions of mental power, and birds, all souls in different forms, cannot hurt us. Even our attendants and servants cannot be touched by anyone in the three worlds. And yet, who is this person? Karadushana mohi sama balavanta tinahi komarai binu bhagavanta. Who is this person who killed Karadushana and Trishira? Surely, it must be the work of God. And he figured out correctly. Suraranjana bhanjana mahibhara jo bhagavanta linha avatara. Delighter of gods, reliever of burden from the earth goddess, that if God has incarnated, this is my opportunity. So mai jai bairu khati karam prabhu sar pran taje bhavataram. I will insist on creating fight against Rama. Why? So that I may attain salvation. This is called bairi bhakti. Devotion sustained by inimical sentiment. This is not advice for good people. Put it first point to understand. Remember different types of devotion. Shantaras, where you don't have any special expression in your practice, you are calm, relaxed, and continue to love God, then called Shantaras. You are Shantabhav, Shantabhakti. Devotees who develop the sentiment of Vatsalya, they are like father loving a baby, like a mother loving a baby. You are loving God with that type of pure love. Or God is the father and you are a baby. If that sentiment maintained, that's called Vatsalya Bhava. When you maintain friendly attitude, like Krishna and Arjuna, then that's called Sakya Bhava. And when you maintain amorous attitude, attitude of supreme love. Rama is a love absolute. Then it's called Madhurya Bhav, sweet disposition. And when you develop the idea, let me be sublimated by Rama. Let me be killed by Rama so that I may attain salvation. Then that's called Bhairi Bhav. Try to understand these bhavas are all mixed up in every personality. The predominant bhav, predominant sentiment becomes your characteristic of devotion. Just like all yogas are always there in your personality. But you can be called karma yogi, you can be called bhakti yogi, dhyana yogi, jnana yogi. But no matter what you call yourself, other yogas are also with you. Similarly, you can call yourself a vatsalya bhakta, a devotion where God is father, you are just a baby. Or you are father, mother, and God is just a baby. That type of devotion. All these sentiments come in different proportions. There will be always a little. When you open your heart to promote love, bhakti, then all these sentiments play their role. Sometimes you are frustrated by God. There comes the attitude of animosity. Bhairi bhakti. You God, why did you get a headache before you created the world? I'm joking. Because even behind that inimical sentiment, there is a deep awakening of the need to confront God, need to face God. And need facing God is the central purpose of your bhakti movement. ओ यही भजन न तामस देहा मन क्रम वचन मंत्र दृढ़ एहा. In this tamasic body, it's not possible for me to do my bhajan, kirtan and all sadhana. Therefore, jo nar roop bhop sut ko hari hau nari ji tiran do. And if he is not God, just human being, I will conquer him and snatch his wife from him. If he is God, I will attain salvation. So both ways, I have nothing to lose. That's called dono hatha mein laddu hai. Laddu is sweet. You are going to get sweet either this hand, or both hands. Chala akel jaan charita hawa bas marich sindhu tatar jahwa. Ravana riding on his demoniac chariot alone went to demon Maricha, who was his great attendant. Iha Ram jasi jugati banai sunahu maso katha suhai. Lord Shiva is telling Parvati. The entire Ramayana has been presented as Shiva telling Parvati, Kagabhushundi telling birds, Tulsidas ji telling saints, and so forth. Lachiman gaye banahi jab, Lachiman gaye banahi jablena mula phala kand janaka sutasana bole bihasi kripa sukha brind. Now what was Rama doing in the meantime? Lakshmana had gone away collecting fruits, roots and other materials needed for the kitchen, while Rama was alone with Sita. So in that setup, Rama said to Sita with a smiling face, Rama, who is the embodiment of Ananda bliss, an embodiment of grace. Sunahu priya brat ruchira sushila, mai kachu karabi lalitar nar leela. O beloved Sita, I am going to do some human acting, human leela. I'm going to act like a human being. I've incarnated as a human, in the human race, as a human being, and now I must perform the purpose of my incarnation. And that purpose is to destroy Ravana. And I need your presence, real you. Tumha pavak mahu karahu nivasa, jau lagi karahu nishachar nasa. Until I destroy Ravana, try to abide in the arms of fire god and keep your shadow behind. Your shadow will look exactly like you. In other words, viveka buddhi, operation viveka buddhi in an aspirant. The reality behind your viveka buddhi is absolute prakriti, that is same as Brahman. So the moment viveka buddhi has started, a shadow of the highest wisdom has begun to grow within your heart, even though their life will be full of challenges. Jabahi Rama sabakathaba kaaba khani prabhupad dhari ya anal samani. When Rama told all this, Sita, bowing down to the feet of Rama, entered into fire god. This shouldn't be taken all literally, these are all allegorical. Where is Sita? Fire represents vairagya, dispassion. Remember, the Uttarayana movement begins with fire, agni jyotiyah shukla. And you are following the path of Uttarayana is to be blended with intuitive knowledge, the real Sita. And that real Sita has started in the very first entry. Fire God is the one who is holding, as it were, deep in his heart, Sita. And you have to discover Sita. Jabahi Ram sabakaha bakhani prabhupad dhari hiya anal samani. When Rama told all this, Sita, having bowed to the feet of Rama, entered into fire god, and left behind a shadow form which looked exactly like her, in her gentleness, in her beauty, in her humility. Lachiman ho yaha maramuna jana yo kachu charitra cha bhagavana. Even Lakshmana did not know what has happened at this stage. dhyana movement is a sadhana movement. If you know what you want to gain, if you have already realization, you don't need dhyana. Lakshmana is that role of dhyana movement. So in this stage, dhyana doesn't exactly know where is Sita, who is Sita. The real nature of Sita, dhyana doesn't know, but works to help Rama to be united with Sita. Dashamukh gayau jahan maricha nai mat swarath ratnicha. And wicked Ravana went to where demon Maricha was, and there, having gone, he bowed his head before Maricha. Navani niche kai ati dukhadai jimi angush danu urag bilai. When wicked people show humility, it means something terrible is going to happen. The poetic description, just like a thorn shows its humility, gets inside your body. It's terrible. The bow, when we stretch the bow bends, becomes humble. But it's terrible. The arrow will shoot it. Snake, the snake is bending down its hood, it's terrible, it's going to bite it. When a cat bends his head down, that also is, cat is going to attack him. Bhayadayak khalkai priyabani, jimiya kalke kusum bhavani. And the words coming out of wicked people, even if they are very sweet, they are like flowers appearing at a time when it was not a season for their blossoming. Somehow it's a artificial flower. Kari puja marich tab sadar puchi baat. Kavan hetu man vyagrati akhtar ayautat. Maricha, having adored Ravana, with great respect asked, oh child, Maricha was elderly, and his elder relationship with Ravana. He asked, oh Ravana, what has made you so sad and in distress? And you have come alone. Why? And for answer, you have to wait. Om Ram 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 Ram. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om. Prayer for shower of Karunamaya, grace of God over all of you, with the blessings of Shakti, Bhakti and Mukti. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukum Bandhanan Mrityor Mukshyama Mritat. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina Sarve Santu Nidamaya Sarve Bhadrani Pashyant Ma Kashchid Dukh Bhag Bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om.